Twitter, Opie Radio. I was with Roland walking around. There's two videos of me with Roland. The other one's a good story that we can tell after the break.
Roland, yes. We're walking and we just ran into a Uber fan.
I'm like shaking, look at me.
Why are you shaking?
Because I listen every day since I was 15. I'm 21.
Oh, you've been listening for 6 years?
Yeah.
And I'm your favorite, right?
You're my...
What is wrong with her?
Well, her mouth is crooked.
First of all, her taste in radio.
She's a big fan.
She's a bit off.
Yeah, but you know,
Danny, I saw you cover your mouth.
It's
what's
really
wrong?
It's really cool to have Rumor Willis as a fan. That's really cool.
Oh, wow. It might be just a jaw thing. Well, but what about her left eye?
Well, we need more time on that.
And then someone wants to know if it's a tranny that the operation went bad.
No.
It's not a tranny?
But does she...
And does she have, like, two real eyes?
Oh,
there's a lot going on here.
I don't know if
she's like a cartoon character.
It might be two inside, I guess, but her face is shaped like the episode of Always Sunny when they think that Dennis is a child molester.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Do you remember how he had that prosthetic on where he had this big, round, awful face?
All right, continue.
Oh, yeah, that's me. Hang on.
Favorite.
Why?
Today you're so funny.
Today was funny?
Yeah.
Who are you?
I'm Catherine.
She doesn't listen, but I was actually just telling her about the house slice thing.
Oh, she talks like
me. She was laughing.
Yeah, I was hysterical. That's fine.
Wait, about what?
Today when you were talking about like the half slices.
The half slices.
Yeah.
That's like a gay pizza joint that Jay Moore wants to sell. Because like gays, you know, they want to watch their figures, so they only want half a slice, right? Funny, right? Roland, I think I found a girl for you. You want to go out with Roland?
I would love... I said he was cute. I commented... I said I wanted to poke him.
Oh, you want to tickle him? Go ahead. This is what happens.
You're evil. Oh, my God.
Isn't that amazing?
That's amazing.
Just amazing. All right.
Amazing.
So you want a picture or something?
Yeah. What?
He's got the camera.
She's shaking. She has a camera.
Oh. Is the camera set?
Yeah, hold on.
We're running away.
Oh no.
We ran away. See, that's the punchline. We ran away from the monster who wanted a picture.
She wasn't bad. She seemed like a fine enough looking gal.
She was kind of cute.
What do you think her problem is? Jay Moore has entered the studio.
I think she had a
I ran
stroke.
Down the hallway because I heard Mushmouth was here. I was like, oh my God.
It's the first time you exercised this month.
It's true.
Wow.
Good he one. Attacked me. Wait. I attacked back.
How about you shut up before I get rolling in here to kick your ass again?
Oh, remember that? You weren't even here.
I was here.
No.
No, we heard about
I'm
it.
I'm always here, bro.
Yeah, I'm crazy. Don't touch his ears.
Well, what do you think's wrong with her, though?
A stroke. She had a stroke as a kid.
A stroke? I'm making fun of someone.
Nah, she's
stroke.
All right.
Yes.
She's
I didn't know her speech was wrong in her face.
She was nice.
I ran into a fan yesterday, and Jay, she liked the half a slice bit that you came up with.
It wasn't me. It was Ronnie.
Ronnie did the half a slice.
Ronnie did half slice, and then I got the giggles because I said it to Paul Reiser.
And then you went with it.
You know, I really slept on this Paul Reiser situation.
Was he in studio?
He was a fucking bore. And here's the I figured out what the problem was.
And we tried.
He sat there and goes, you know, I didn't want to work. I didn't want to write anything. I don't want to act. And then I'm like, then what the fuck are you doing here?
He came into we're comic strip on Friday night. He came in to do guest spots.
You said he tanked.
He did?
He said,
I went on after him. It was so good to have him open because the audience was just so happy to see fucking me. He's stuck in the 80s.
If he's going on in a room, he should be going on at like Gotham or the Cellar because the strip is a younger, like it's not the room it was when he was working it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know what I mean?
No. He just kept telling us how he doesn't want to work and he doesn't want to. I mean, I really like slept on it because Ronnie kept hitting home like how uncomfortable it was. And I didn't really particularly think it was that bizarre as Ronnie like
it was uncomfortable because we weren't getting anything out of him and he's supposed to be a funny guy, he's a comic and there's a room full of funny guys and he had nothing.
Well, I think he just
was really trying sitcom. He won't be working next week.
No, I just
and,
heard
and then he's downplaying the sitcom like it's a middle of the season replacement. He didn't
hey,
even
boss,
think much
what
of
you
his...
said to roll hey Roland. Are you guys square now, Roland and Voss?
Me and Roland go way back now.
All right. I heard he bent you up like a goddamn pretzel.
Oh, boy. He came in. He fucking destroyed me.
Do we
me,
have
man.
That audio?
All right. Well,
all I know
there's the end of that bit.
Here's the whole,
no, no. Listen, yes, he beat me.
This is what bothered me the most. Not the fact that he destroyed me. we were playing Scrabble and I was killing him and he came in and flipped the board. And I was fucking beating him in Scrabble.
Never beaten me in Scrabble.
I was winning by 80 fucking points.
You could win at Scrabble if you don't have to pronounce any of the words. Oh. You just have to lay them down.
You know what? You throw enough against the wall. One sticks.
He's fucking a bad speller, too. He's not a good speller.
Say, I want church on Tuesday. I missed you, Rich. I missed you. I ran down the halls. I swear. I ran down the hall, and they go, oh, Rich Voss is in there. And you lost a little muscle mass yourself with your little front porch you got going. What are you talking about?
You got a little belly. That's true, right? He did a little
bit.
Here
it comes.
Here it comes.
Here it comes.
All right. Old man abs.
Put some underpants on.
I got fucking Iggy Pop abs. After I saw him without his shirt on, I want to stop working out. Fucking horrible. He looks like he looked into the ark. Did you see him?
Too many words.
Jay, right back with the buttons. Listen, we're going to break, Jay, because we've been going an hour. When we get back, we're going to play. You want to play it into break or when we get back? We got the rolling confrontation with Rich Voss.
It's over. It's not over. I'd love to hear it.
We're not going to hear it into break, so we'll play it in show. After the break, we'll do that, okay?
Okay.
And Jay's going to be at
Gotham tonight. Rich, you want to open for me?
Huh?
You want to come to Gotham tonight?
What's today? Today's
Tuesday. You're dark on Tuesday.
I'm off tonight. How much?
Maybe a couple $100.
Yeah, I'll do it.
$200. How much you get for a spot someplace?
I don't do spots. I headline Gotham too. So it would be a...
Well, then come by. Then why am I giving you money at all? Just come by and say hi and do some time for everybody.
I live in Jersey. I'm going to drive home from here and then come all the way back. It's a fucking hour home.
Jay, we just talked finances with Rich. Give him a couple $100, please.
Here's what happened.
Please give him a couple $100.
I called him on his couple hundred things and he reevaluated, said, you know what? Maybe $300 is too much money for a...
Because Joe Matarese, it's just a two-man show.
He's a funny dude, though.
I don't have an MC ever. I hate it.
I have to have a three-man show. Because I piss between the feature and myself. I have to.
I'm pissing shit the entire time the guy's up there for the entire 20 minutes. And then I don't get introduced. They just play music. And then when the music plays and just a blank stage, just walk off stage. They know why they're here. You've seen them on the... That's the great credit. You've seen them on Comedy Central.
Yeah. Why don't you
Your credit.
Why don't you fly in Dina Cola from obscurity and have
him on? No one knows what that means.
Why you make fun of Mike?
I do.
Poor Mike. Five people got that.
Rich. Yeah, I do.
Granted, it's very funny, but only five people.
Nobody
got
wants
that.
The razor sharp mind of an FBI profiler turned on them.
Save that for after the break. That's too much for Jay Moore right now. We got some stuff to explain after the break. Are you doing Gotham?
Hold on. Fucking Rich Voss just pointed at me and said, look at his head.
Rich.
Nice head. Like, what are we, fucking Valley View Road in Verona, New Jersey? Hey, nice head. Don't get wise.
Are you going to do Gotham tonight? Let's negotiate this. Do Jay Moore's Gotham show tonight.
Make fun of me the whole time.
And then Rich is going
to hit Matt Reese on it. How would I do it? You want me to host it?
Yeah, host it.
How about I just bring you up to do some time so I can have a rest?
What do you mean, during your act?
Whatever.
Whenever. He'll fucking...
Fucking horrible.
Hey, I'm not going to fucking, you know...
Whatever.
If you don't want to do it, don't do it.
I'll host it.
But I don't want to fucking go in pocket for no reason.
I'm going to do time. I'll do 20 up
right,
front.
Right, but it's like a luxury that we don't need. Like it's a luxury to
Thank
have you.
You
there because I do think you're hilarious.
He'd love you to do a guest spot.
If I was in town, I would love to do a guest spot.
So just hang out in the city. Just sleep on the subway. Just
ride the subway back and forth.
25 years, I used to do that all the time.
Yeah, and how's it working out for you? You think fucking Selch? You just complained to everybody you have no money.
I have enough. I mean, I keep putting it into this movie.
He's the book himself. He's the book himself. He's no agent.
No booking.
Where's Jason Steinberg?
No, first of all, he was my manager. He wasn't my personal appearance guy.
What's the difference? 5%.
Hey, everybody, we're all going to get laid.
Magic.
Listen, Rich Voss is going to be at Wise Guys Comedy Club, Trolley Square, Salt Lake City, Friday and Saturday.
That place is the best.
Jay, save it. We're going to break it. We'll rock until
Salt
10,
Lake
no
City.
Problem.
Go see Rich Voss.
And Jay Moore tonight at Gotham. We'll continue.
Virus, Sirius XM. This is the Opie and Anthony Show. Opie and Anthony.
All right, now it's me and Rich. Lost Jay Moore and Jim Norton. I don't have anything to say to you.
I know, I'm tired.
We've hung out enough. Yeah. I don't have any questions for you anymore.
When are you taking me out to dinner and Bonnie for sushi?
You know what? I think this is the last show until Anthony gets back, so.
Well.
I think I'm going to fucking shut her down and take a few days myself. So, you want to play golf?
Yes.
Are you around?
Next week? I'll be back Monday.
No, I can play golf tomorrow or Thursday.
I can't play Thursday. I can play tomorrow. But it's going to rain tomorrow.
Oh, it is? All right, we'll figure it out after the show.
I'll play next week, definitely.
Yeah.
Are you off next week?
No. It took 2 weeks, and yeah, a lot of people are confused, but I have a kid. I can't go anywhere. It's tough to go on vacation. He's 11 months now. And my girl's still at school and doing other stuff, so we're fucking locked up. So I'm like, am I going to sit home for 2 weeks, or can I come in and do a few shows? So I decided to do a few shows. And now I'll take a few days off and relax a little bit. That's all. I usually go away, but this is one of those years I don't think I could do that.
Why? Take the baby on a trip.
I'm not ready. When did you start taking the baby on the trip,
Too
Jay?
Early.
It's too early, right?
I took my son to Hawaii when he's like 3 years old.
Well, three? I'm talking about an 11-month-old.
Well, if you don't mind, do you have a nanny?
No.
Where do you want to go?
We don't trust anyone yet.
What do you mean you don't trust anybody yet?
I don't trust anyone yet.
You trust yourself?
Barely.
You just ran away from a fat girl in the street.
Barely. I barely. Leave our kids. And my kid was strapped to me, by the way. He was like, what the hell are you doing?
You clown.
He gave me a what the hell are you doing look.
You running up Fifth Avenue like Earl Campbell.
Right. Away from that
He's
monster.
From my hometown.
No one cares.
Tyler, Texas?
Oh, no. I meant Milt Campbell.
Huh?
Milt Campbell.
I learned something from Jay. I'll say it again. I learned something from Jay's book. Don't do anything significant with your kid until at least three or four.
What are you talking about?
Because they don't remember anything
of it.
What?
That's not true.
Earliest memory. Go.
What's your memory? Not the memory your parents told you. You remember, you wore those little cowboy boots?
I remember once walking down to the river, to the brook, getting undressed and walking home naked when all the kids were getting out from school. I remember walking
How
to
old
the
Do you remember the older man that took you there and brutally sodomized you by the rocks?
And made you walk home by yourself without your clothes?
Put your little Jewish face in the mud.
I like how Rich... Rich can't think of an answer, so he just looks at Jimmy and goes, huh? Like, so Jimmy will repeat it so he can think of a fucking joke.
That's how you do it. You go, what?
But how old were you, Rich?
I was probably three.
You remember walking around naked in Jersey?
Yes, I remember walking into the basement, taking a shit in the basement, just taking a dump on the floor.
At three-ish?
Yeah.
What about that's not antisocial behavior.
Yeah, what about you, Jimmy? Earliest memory.
Being at Turtleback Zoo, I vaguely
remember. Yeah, visiting relatives.
Yeah.
Boss.
Fuck.
That was a great one.
Oh boy, that's a knockout punch.
Yes, I was a Turtleback Zoo when I was young.
How old were you?
11.
Perfect. Nothing was better than the other day when you go, you're just a great comic, and just congratulations on everything. And Richard Gervais goes, oh, thanks, mate. He goes, I was talking to Louis. Anyway, my first memory was I was at the Passaic River with my parents and we were having a picnic and a naked Jewish kid walked up and he said, what's everybody staring at me for? Who's seeing my diaper? I'm wearing Huggies 11 now. I'm a big boy. No, it was like looking up the street, just weird snippets
really?
Of like.
How old?
I would say four. But that's like we're talking about like a slideshow of a memory, like one photo, like
that's
you don't,
a frame.
Like you don't remember, like going on like Barnegat Bay and fishing at like 4 years old. Like, come on, we'll take him. It'll be great.
Right.
Well, my son doesn't remember shit that happened at school that day. It's like they wipe his fucking slate clean every day.
Fucking Dr. Moore, you remember things you know that you.
He's saving
here's
people
the thing.
A lot
here's,
of money.
Well, stop it. Listen to me. Here's the thing.
Excuse me.
With kids, whether they remember or not, a kid. His foundation is being with his parents, being loved, and they know they'll
How
grow.
How would you know?
Don't listen.
You're not loved.
He knows what I'm talking. So if your kid is with you on vacation and this and that, there might not be memories of the vacation,
but the energy,
the feeling of love will translate.
Yeah, but you don't need to go to Disney to get that done.
Don't you think I love my child just as much in the Pacific Palisades?
Exactly. Not as much as you would love him in Hawaii.
And Hawaii is a pain in my ass. He's the reason I'm not sleeping till noon because of this kid.
Right.
You know what I'm saying.
The
memories are there, but...
But he's right. You can do those memories at home.
And you could also go on vacation and do them, too. You do not go on vacation because you have a kid.
Here's my book. I'm going to just read from it.
And you'll be the only one.
Yeah, it's funny. It'd be funny if it wasn't on the New York Times list.
Every book is. Okay, I didn't even write a book, and it's on there.
What's it called?
It's called I Didn't Write a Book, and it's on there. It's called...
Every book doesn't make
the list.
Not even close.
Every book doesn't
make the list. You've got to sell 6,000 books to crack the top 15 on that list.
6,000?
In the first weekend.
Huh.
Don't chew gum into the mic. It's bad enough.
We gave up on that.
It's Nicorette gum.
With your Warren Beatty teeth.
Nicorette gum.
Brand
for
new,
33,000
implants.
You're the only guy I know that brags about terrible shit.
You want to see the YouTube? You want to see
something
fucking gross?
You want to see my teeth? $33,000.
Listen to me, Elephant Man. Go to YouTube. Go to fucking YouTube. And go, you'll see the grossest thing. They filmed it. When they're shooting Nova, it's fucking...
It is a good video. You without teeth is disturbing. Really quickly, from the Nicorette website, hold on. The recommended course of therapy is 12 weeks for the gum.
Yeah,
you've been on it for 5 years.
Yeah,
and then
I was
in
on
big
cocaine
letters,
for 20-something years.
All right, that's a good point. Good point. I'm going to stop. You got me.
You're going to Trolley Square, Wise Guys.
Yeah,
that's the room that holds 80 people.
It's like 100 people.
No, it's... All right, sorry.
Yeah, 80. Yeah, it's not a lot. Yeah, you're right. So what
are you
saying?
With 100 people?
Don't make him feel bad.
I fly across the country.
Jay, don't make him feel bad.
I
told him it's like my favorite city.
I'm getting the money I need.
This much?
Huh? No. What are you kidding me? I wouldn't do that over the phone.
You missed the hour before you got here, Jay. It's very depressing.
No.
Ask him what he does on the
depressing.
Road. Ask him what he does on the road besides play golf.
I have the elephant man's head. Who gives a fuck about his finances?
No,
I obviously
this
need
is not a
doctor. A
finance thing.
I'm John Merrick. You talk like the fucking guy.
Okay, so we can do it.
You gotta sleep in a fucking chair.
There's a difference. I don't have to talk. We still have to look at you. Here's the difference.
You do have to talk, Rich.
That's your fucking job.
That's your whole fucking life.
You have to talk.
There's only
80
people there. They don't care.
You look a guy hitting zero that just bats fucking leadoff every night.
I never fail on stage.
Rich,
never.
Tell Jay Moore what you do on the road besides play golf because it's deeply depressing and we got to.
I forgot.
Hear it again.
What do I do?
He makes believe. Ready for this?
Oh,
that he's an FBI profiler.
They say, what do you do for a living?
On the golf course, because you don't want to talk about comedy.
No, but he wants to talk about being an FBI profiler.
Right.
He's living out this fantasy of just being a smart guy.
Very smart.
And then we asked.
Very smart.
And then we asked him basic shit that he didn't know the names of the serial killers that he was profiling.
But here's the thing. The public doesn't know those questions that you know.
He probably dropped the guy in Long Island off. He had no idea it was him.
There's a serial killer.
Yeah,
yeah,
I know.
Rich.
They found body 10.
Okay. Did they? Oh, yes. Let's hear a little bit about it.
Yeah, you're the FBI profiler.
They went past their perimeter, and they're outside the perimeter, and they went
farther. Who's they?
First of all, it's called his comfort zone. It's not called the perimeter.
No, the perimeter where the bodies were found.
You need the lingo.
Comfort zone.
The comfort zone is where he kills or his comfort
and
for
they
killing.
Went, they went outside his comfort zone.
No, they went outside the perimeter of where the bodies were found, the other 8 bodies.
That's the
Which
comfort
would be the
zone.
Fucking comfort zone.
No, the comfort zone is where he is killing in his comfort zone.
When did
zone.
You get that shirt back to a black act?
I would, but I don't know his real name.
It's a rugby shirt.
Should JB Smoove?
Smoove.
Ruckus!
And tell me about the lookouts.
What?
He's got lookouts.
The minor league team? The Chattanooga lookouts?
He's got lookouts.
So anyhow, let's get back to Wise Guys.
No, when he's in the FBI, you got lookouts.
Yeah, you got lookouts.
You want to call someone from the FBI?
You got one?
Tell me about the lookouts.
Well, when we were digging up the fake bodies in Atlanta, we had lookouts. To see who was in the crowd and if there was any white people, and there was no white people, so we knew that the serial killer wasn't white. That's all. You know, it's hard to explain serial killers.
Serial killers are normally white, yeah.
I know, but this one was black in Atlanta.
There's a lot more black ones than you think, though. They just
kill
their
fucking white girls.
Jesus. They're just killing their own race.
What did you say, Rich?
Nothing. All right. So, tell me about Wise Guys. If you know the room, obviously you work there.
No, it's because I play the big room, and then you go, well, who's in the little room? It's adorable.
Oh, that's me.
Trolley Square.
I'm looking forward to this. It's I love it.
And Keith Stubbs is great. The owner's great.
Yeah.
And Salt Lake City is the coolest town. It's the cleanest.
I would offer to go there. I've never been.
You gotta go.
Really?
Yeah.
I hear nothing but good things
it's
about
it. It's so clean and great.
I already said it.
It's incredible. And the more, like, I had this whole preconceived notion of Mormons. They're the fucking best. The whole religion is based on fucking hanging out with your family. Not the polygamists, the real, you know, the OG Mormons.
What do you do in Salt Lake, though? What's there to do?
I'm going
to
play golf.
Where do you go anywhere? I mean, you guys, do you do shit on the road? I just fucking sleep and watch Law and Order.
Depends. So, Law and Order's the worst. Have you ever seen a black criminal on that fucking show? No. They're all white.
No.
Yes. Every killer on Law, crook on Law and Order is white.
What about Ice-T? You ever see the gay, when Ice-T had to break up the gay black athlete ring?
No.
There's like gay black. I didn't even know what the crime was on SVU. I didn't even know what the crime was. And apparently, like a quarterback, one of them had HIV and he was like spreading HIV to other athletes and was going to ruin the whole league. It was like a fucking Scooby Doo episode. It was bizarre. And he goes undercover and he goes to like barbecues and shit. And then he comes back in like halfway through the episode. You didn't see this?
Nice.
Halfway through the episode, he comes in and he goes, turns out I'm man Jesse O'Brien. He's on the down low. And then he leaves. Like, that's his undercover work. Like, there's no photography, no written report. There's no, like, you know, no one wore a white. He just goes, he comes in his floor-length sweeper, leather coat, and goes, he's on the down low. And he leaves, and then they go fucking break it up.
They're doing a Law & Order Portland next year.
Why'd you do that?
Why? I watched some of Law & Order LA last night for the first time.
I love it.
Do you?
I like love that. It. The lead guy who was in Spider-Man is good.
Molina?
Is that his name? Yeah.
Let's call
what did you
FBI?
Watch last night?
What do you want to ask an FBI man?
Man.
Let's talk to a real FBI person.
I don't want... I'm going to call a CIA guy. We all have phone numbers, okay?
You got to tell him he's on the air before you off the air first. You can't just put him on.
I'm going to have him take care of you when you go up to Salt Lake.
You can't just have him into the mic. Jay, you can't just do that.
All right, well, I can have a conversation amongst yourself. Hey, Matt, it's Jay Moore. You're on radio, so don't curse.
You can curse. It's...
My friend.
I turned it down.
How do I put it?
What? Oh, no, not... Is
he
all
right? Now.
Yeah.
That's all right. All right.
All right. Are you all right to be on the radio?
Yeah, just put him on speaker and throw the phone next to the fucking microphone.
What do you
microphone.
Sound very busy?
Try the crime scene.
It's probably digging up bodies on the beach.
Utah.
I got a comic.
He's outside. Long Island, you asshole.
I got a comedian coming up. He's playing Trolley Square. When you going there? Friday and Saturday. This guy's really great. Are you going to be up there at that time? All right. His name is Rich Voss.
Please arrest him.
Who?
Voss is coming in. Look at Voss, has juice with the feds.
Yeah, fellow profiler.
Yeah, we were just making fun of him because when he plays golf, he tells the people he's golfing with that he's an FBI profiler. So I said, you'll get along great with Trump, with Doormat Trump.
Ask him if he read John Douglas books.
All right, go break Voss's balls when he comes up there, okay?
Ask him if he read John Douglas.
He started.
I know who he is.
Journey into Darkness.
Yeah, I know. I know who Robert Ressler is. I know who they
all three of them.
That was fucking dull radio. Sorry.
That's all right.
I thought it'd be more exciting.
Is he from Salt Lake?
Yeah.
What are the odds that you have an FBI, guy's card in your wallet?
I got about 14 states.
And why do you keep a wallet in your front pocket?
So girls can check out my ass.
It's also not bad. It's bad for you to sit on your wallet. It's very bad for your back.
Not your wallet, because there's nothing in it, Rich.
Yeah, your wallet's fine.
So why are you financial straight?
It's crazy. One Discover card.
It's crazy.
One Discover card.
Diner Club.
Radio Shack Battery Club card. Why are you in financial straight?
You just hit the hat trick on that one.
That was funny.
Why am I what?
Funny stuff.
What part of that run wasn't funny?
Exactly. Yeah,
that was a good run, Rich.
It was about me.
He said Discover. He said Diners.
I started with the thin wallet.
Batteries Club card. That's a fucking comedy pyramid.
What was your question you asked?
Why? I wasn't here when we were talking about your financial straits. What's happening with you,
nothing,
man?
Nothing.
He books himself.
You know this
business. What do you mean nothing? I come in and Opie goes, oh, my God, wait
no,
a minute.
I'm not making
it. It was a set out. Problem. And you're like, nothing's wrong.
No, I'm financing our movie. So I'm going
what
on the
movie?
Road. Bonnie and I are making a movie called Women Aren't Funny. It's a comedy documentary. Everybody's in it.
Big. Why didn't you get Jay Moore's?
He was in L.A. and, you know.
Is it too late to get
Jay Moore's?
We're getting big acts.
Once you get Jay Moore, it's not too late.
We're done filming. We thought we would throw him in maybe for a cameo.
You know what my album's, my special's called?
No.
Funny for a Girl.
Yeah.
So it's interesting that you had a whole thing.
Women aren't funny that we have copyrighted. Anyhow.
I'm not using your title. I'm just saying. Relax, Rich. No one's going to steal your idea at this point.
So, are you kidding me? This is a... Believe you me, this is a fucking it's a great project.
Yeah, tiny, horrible hands you have.
Okay, really?
Come on, Matt Roloff, finish your story. I like that. Vinny Brand sounds just like him, too.
Like who?
You got to know
Matt Roloff. Come on, stiff fingers.
You have Vinny Brand on.
Come on, open up a fucking pumpkin patch or finish your story. One or the other.
Exactly. Do a magical dance, would you?
You're really doing little people, big world humor for 10 people out there.
Tell us a fucking riddle. Come on. Yeah, exactly. No, for real. What's going on with your finances? Sure.
Nothing. I mean, I'm not making the money I was making.
Why not?
But I will. It goes side up and shows down. You know the business goes up and down.
No, just pretty. It's kind of like just a nice plateau for guys like Jimmy and I.
Only goes up.
Well.
Why did it go down for you?
Can you take the
economy? Why? Because I'm not doing the numbers I was doing.
No one is.
And I'll tell you, huh?
No one is.
The economy's low. Now,
Jimmy is.
In some places.
Well,
come on.
Fucking 5 sold out shows in Columbus?
Yeah, that was good.
Fuck it. You had to play for Ohio State to fucking make that happen.
Yeah, it was
good. It'd be Nick Mangold. I know it wasn't that funny, Rich. You know the fucking critique. One thing about Rich, it's like the fucking comedy police.
I wasn't even paying attention. If I was comedy police, you'd be arrested 10 times over. But I wasn't paying attention. I was daydreaming about what you,
the big case.
Keeping on why numbers are down. And
daydreaming about why numbers are there.
Well, no, exactly.
After last
why did you
comic,
say thinking
after because I was daydreaming. After last comic, when we went on tour, we were selling out fucking theaters and clubs. But
by the way,
I couldn't. Huh?
You're lucky I didn't take you guys to fucking court. You went out on tour with a fucking show name that I created.
No, that's not
the
true.
Last comics.
No, you're wrong. We went
Last Comic Standing 2, T-O-O.
No, Comics of Last Comic. It's just like saying
Comics of Last Comic Standing is my fucking show. Where's my taste?
No, huh? Where's your taste?
You motherfucker.
Listen to me. I made that show, so shut the fuck up.
You did, man. You were fantastic on the show. I lobbied for you to be on it.
You lobbied.
You should be a little fucking nicer to me.
You fucking lobbied for me to be on it. You guys begged me. I was going to say no to it.
And what did I say?
And what did you say? You called me and said, do the show. And I said, okay.
Rich, I will never in my life try to convince someone to be on television. That's what I said to you.
That's true.
Whatever.
I said, I'm never going to call someone and try to convince them they should be on television.
So who was on the
tour? How is that me begging you to be on the fucking
show? Because you called me and we talked for 40 minutes.
What part? When you fucking went and auditioned for the show, that's me calling you and begging you?
No, listen to me,
dummy.
You
went and stood in line like a fucking herb.
No, I didn't, you fucking Jamoke. Listen, I went to the first...
He said Jamoke was going to get a big laugh.
No,
he fucking paused. He said Jamoke and fucking
usually don't pause.
You fucking Jamoke.
I'm not going to fight everybody.
Is there a real issue here with you and Jay?
No, I like
I'm feeling so
I played fucking golf with him. I showed him my asshole. What are you kidding me?
We've all seen your asshole,
talk out of it.
That's a lie to you. That's not special. We've all seen the
But the thing with Rich...
With me and Jay is...
You guys got a real issue that goes way back? Are you kidding me? I think Rich is hilarious. But for Rich to go, like, you begged me to be...
No,
there.
I didn't say that.
That's weird.
You just said that.
Okay, here's the thing. But you said before that...
who was on the tour?
What did you say before that?
Exactly. It's
you
not
went on,
tour.
You went on
who,
tour.
Who went on the tour?
With a Last Comic Standing tour.
It wasn't. It was me, Dave, and Corey, the first season.
And those are three people
that
run a show called what? Last Comic Standing. Yes. What was the name of the tour?
Rich, Dave, and Corey.
That's not the fucking name of the tour.
There was no name of the tour.
It's a fucking internet in front of me.
He's scared that you still want your taste.
There's no possible. When you say comics from Last Comic Standing.
That's my show.
You're right. But it's not saying Last Comic Standing tour.
What if right now...
I could go on tour right now and say comics from Opie and Anthony, and I wouldn't have to.
No, you couldn't.
No way, man.
I could say comics from... Yes, I could.
You couldn't mark
from Opie and Anthony.
What fucking planet are you from?
That you
can go out on tour and market your tour comics from the Opie and Anthony show without Opie getting a fucking
bite. You're saying when you go on the road, you can't use any of your television credits.
No, it's not using your credits. You're selling
the name of the show
as their show.
Yeah, you can't.
Yeah.
No, I'm saying comics from...
We understand what from means.
Get a lawyer on the phone. Get a lawyer on the phone.
You're a fucking Jew. Call one.
I don't need get a lawyer on the phone. Get a lawyer on the phone.
You're getting nervous that he's going to ask for his
case.
Yeah, you kidding me?
Yeah.
All right. So you were doing theaters.
And the reason I didn't hold on to that audience because the people that used to watch Last Comic Standing.
The people, though.
Okay. expected clean television, and then they come to see me live, and I'm talking about hot loads on their back, and that's
all
they're used to.
It's also hard because then there's a new crop every year of people.
But then season two.
You were in season one, right?
He was on twice. He was on season two seasons.
One,
you
got two.
And I made it to the finals to the end in both. That's how powerful Rich Voss is, bitches. Okay?
You know, if you guys
were so powerful, you're playing in front of
If they were on the
Utah,
air, if they were still
Trolley Square.
If they were on the air, I would have won.
You would have won. If you guys were on the air, he would have won.
Season one?
Yeah.
We were on the air at that point?
You had a square asshole, you shit bricks? I don't want to hear that shit.
You remember you were taking pictures of me in Montreal?
It fucking killed me, trust me.
I remember. Sorry.
You heard that story? All of a sudden, these girls come up to us, can I get a picture? I'm like, yeah, of course. I'm open for my... And all of a sudden, they hand me the camera. They want a picture of Rich Voss. It was the worst day of my life.
Wow. That's a big...
It was the worst day of my life.
That's a precipitous drop.
And Rich has never let me forget that, by the way. Was that a bummer?
Two planes collided on the runway.
JFK.
A fender bender on the fucking tarmac.
You would think they would have that figured out by
now. First season was fucking great.
But how do you... I like how you got off the your point of you don't have to give money to me for saying comedians of Last Comic Standing.
Well, first of all, I don't. And second of all, if I had to give money to anybody, it would be to Peter Engel. Right?
Who was my partner? Me and Peter Engel split our back end.
Well, I already paid him, so you better get your money from him.
You still get a
he owes you some money? No, what are you? I'm paying
you still get a piece of that, right?
You get a taste,
Jay? Creator?
Yeah. You still get a taste? It's NBC, and then me and Peter, it's split three ways.
I'll tell you that one fucking girl, Eliza, looked good last year on TV.
Eliza?
I looked at her.
I, she,
Schlesinger?
Yeah, she looked
I
fucking
feel like, good. I feel like girls.
She's, is she pretty?
I've met her.
Right, up close. She's all right.
She's cute,
got a nice
but I don't
body.
I thought girls
are
funny.
Did she win? I'm trying to talk to you.
I didn't say, who said, I said pretty.
No, you said.
She was good when I worked with her. I didn't say they weren't.
Did she win or no?
Yes. You freak.
No, you don't like being
Look tough. At that. She looks good in that.
Let me see. Yeah, wow, she doesn't. She's actually
Bonnie's really... a beautiful girl.
Yeah.
She doesn't think so anymore.
I do too.
Not really.
She let herself go?
No.
We see it in your eyes. You don't think so anymore.
She's all right.
Is she get put on some pounds?
I like the way her hand is positioned on her hip.
That's good.
Bonnie's, she's a real
Bonnie's fucking hot, Rich.
She's good.
What's wrong with you?
They're hot. You know, it's so funny when I don't see it. But here's the thing: when
you don't see that Bonnie's hot.
No, she was hot when I first met. She's
what
hot.
What about when you look at Neil Brennan? You go, yeah, Bonnie is hot.
That's hilarious.
What's going on with you two?
Isn't he making
nothing?
There's nothing
going
on.
This is the Paul Reiser thing happening.
No, there's nothing going on.
Why did you
here?
Have a problem with Paul?
We had Paul Reiser yesterday. We don't want to go back to the Paul Reiser
thing. Did you fucking listen to what we were just talking about? I didn't know if you two had a fight.
He's too busy thinking of one-liners about the elephant, man.
Yeah. I didn't go back to that. Let it go. I didn't know if you guys were arguing.
Okay, Rocky, Dennis. I know it's not funny. I just wanted to strip it from you.
Yeah, you should be like Rocky Balboa or something.
Oh, yeah.
Word.
People are...
You want to move on?
Can you... I like people, the whole...
you want to go to the phones?
Jay Moore is an intellectual bully.
People are begging you to stop chewing the fucking gum.
Yeah, it's
they're
really
begging
annoying.
At this point. You're going to be all right without the gum?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah, really, they're begging.
Frank and Bill?
No, it's chomp. It is
what's
a bit loud. You can hear it?
Yeah, no, you're doing it to a microphone.
All right, relax.
Oh, wait, here's a lawyer from Jersey. You're fucked.
Which one?
Rob.
All right, let's go to Rob in Jersey. Rob.
Voss, you're a fucking idiot.
Shut up, jerk off. You're a lawyer.
Yeah. Good one. How do you think you're going to use somebody's name and not pay them?
I'm not using their fucking name.
If you
I'm
say
saying from.
Comics from the Opie and Anthony show, we would technically want a piece of that.
What's that?
I would never do that
no,
to you.
No, because how about this? When people say, when people do fucking half hour specials on Comedy Central, they go from Comedy Central.
You can tell yourself
Comedy
whatever
Central
you
presents.
Want. Using it to sell the show is different than
that's
listening
the same
to it.
If
you're marketing
no, true,
it as
every,
the comics from Opie and Anthony, that
okay.
could
every
mean
club
we would get a
markets
taste.
Your credits. Every club markets your credits. If you're going into a club and they're going to,
I understand it, but if the
Kim
name...
Kim Norton from Louis C. What was that show that you
yeah,
guys
Lucky
did?
Louis.
Lucky
I understand
Louis.
That.
Okay, you're using the name
but
to
that's
market.
Not that, I'm coming in as Jim Norton. I'm not saying...
Okay, then we're coming in
Hold
Rich
on.
Boss.
How about we ask
last
a lawyer?
Standing.
Seriously, you're... Oh,
are you
he
an...
Enter- He's gone.
Rich, yeah, because
if
he
you're
knew
marketing
he was wrong,
yourself...
All right, let me go to Maddie in Rhode Island. Hold on, Rich. One for you. This guy is on your side.
Oh,
go ahead,
boy,
Maddie.
Here we go.
show.
Go ahead, Matt.
Hey, first of all, foremost, yesterday, phenomenal show. Jay, you had me cracking up with that monkey story. That, I mean, you are a phenomenal talent. But, man, you are so fast and so clever. You have this way of just calming over. And before someone can even respond to you, you're on to the next thing. You take over the show. There's only one other man I've ever heard in the history of ONA that could take over the show, and that's Dice. And, man, you take over, man. And I understand O brings you in, whoever. Please just give them some breathing space to let us
I disagree.
I agree.
As I talk over them. I agree with the guy. The one thing I want to change about myself for the last 15 years is I fucking talk too much.
No, I got to say, man, I mean, the run we've had with Jay the last week and a half has been great. It really has been great.
Is he a lawyer, this guy?
No, unfortunately.
Did he sound like a lawyer?
Jay, you can't agree with that. It's been great. It's been a great run.
Listen,
you've seen
Voss's last tweet is, I'm at the library with Kid. Too fucking quiet in here.
Why would you tweet that?
Exactly. Spelled it L-I-B-E-R-R-Y.
Library.
I spelled two T-O.
That's his favorite cereal, library.
Why do you go to the library? That's like,
I took my daughter there, my 3.5-year-old.
But then you can get that on the internet.
You fucking idiot. She can't play games and run around on the internet.
You shouldn't run around the library.
What do you do at the library?
They have fucking...
You're getting shit for going to a place. Like, you get shit for being stupid, and then you go to the library, and you get shit for going to the
homeless.
What are you doing with fucking books and shit, man?
Libraries are for homeless people at this point. No one really goes.
Not where I live. Yeah, they do.
So what do they do at the library?
They have readings. They have activities for kids. They have all different stuff. The other night, we went to a soup tasting thing.
So you went to a soup tasting?
Yeah, that was Bonnie's idea.
Soup.
You fucking assholes went and tasted soup.
It was Bonnie's idea.
Why don't you make your own?
Because there was five or six restaurants from our hometown.
Ooh,
they had soup tasting.
Name the soups.
It was something to do.
Hold on. Name the soups.
I don't fucking remember the soups.
You don't remember the soups?
There was
the
Polish soup from the Polish restaurant.
You sit there and go, ooh, this one's really good. You can really taste the vegetables.
It was like 3 weeks ago. But it was something to do, me and Bonnie, as a husband and wife and a baby, to go and hang out in our town and do something nice. It was a Monday or Tuesday.
Your marriage sucks.
Why do you resent Bonnie?
You're going to soup tastings.
I don't. What the fuck?
Soup tasting is horrible.
I know. We didn't know that until we went.
You know I love you. I try to support you, but soup tasting, I can't get behind.
Okay. You should be tasting it through a hole in a booth. That's how you should have your soup.
Did he have crackers along with it?
Oh, yeah.
Oysterettes. Zilch.
Oysterettes.
With the New England. You take your kid to the library. That's what you do.
My library's fine.
Is this what I have to do soon?
Yes.
Take him to a library?
Well, yeah.
How did you know which building it was? I'm having trouble syncing my fucking new iPad, by the way, to my Kindle.
Not good.
I can't get my books on my new iPad. I'm out of my mind about it.
That's not good.
Do you have a Kindle on your iPad?
Isn't there a Kindle app?
Oh, fuck for.
Shouldn't that be
exactly.
easy?
Why would I read a fucking book on my iPad?
It's all doable.
I stopped reading 5 years when I met Bonnie. I used to read all the time.
No, you didn't.
I did. I got all my books at home. I read. I keep them.
So why don't you fucking, if you just want to prove to yourself that you've read.
Yes.
Why don't you read on your iPad? It's great. It's so light. You can have fucking 50 books on it.
Yeah, well, I'd rather watch a movie.
You want to do an ONA, Comics of ONA tour? I'll take a piece of that.
I already did it. We did it.
The virus show was
what thing. Happened to the other tour you were talking about? What happened to that one?
Which one?
The fucking car crash comedy tour.
We're trying, but we can't get these dummies on the same page.
What, you mean us?
No, the real dummies. We're dumb, but they're
the suit dummies.
Well, how hard is it to put it together?
You would think it'd be easy, but and we don't want to step on Jimmy's toes. Jimmy's doing his thing right now. We might do it.
It's amazing when you book a theater, like the amount of money you have to put out for like a fucking stagehand to stand there and watch you do your fucking show. Like, are you fucking serious? They go, hey, it's union. Fucking, that's a stage show. You need four guys in the room with the curtain. You're like, but I don't use nothing. Nothing's moving.
The expenses are killing the guys down the hall. They can't justify it.
Yeah, the theater expenses are disgusting.
That's
why people do two shows because there's less.
I think
expenses.
A car crash comedy, a short run with that would be fun in a few cities. I think we'd have a good time with that.
You do it in comedy clubs, I guess.
So you know how to do it in a theater. You could do it in a theater at a college where you don't have to pay the union.
We're going to try to figure it out for you, Rich, so you get a few more bucks in your pocket.
College theaters.
I like all the calls that are anti-me.
Where?
What?
Where do you want me to go? I'll go in there.
An intervention on Jay? John, this guy lives in Staten Island.
Let's go to John in Staten Island. John.
Yes. Hey, guys.
Welcome aboard, John.
How long have you been listening to the show?
Long time, huh? I'll take your thoughts off the air.
Quack, quack. Whoa, whoa, hit from all angles. Quack, quack, pork chop. Voss and Jimmy could probably help me out with this one.
Wait, say again?
Jay's been a little uppity. He's been talking over people.
Ooh.
And Voss and Jimmy can probably notice the signs that somebody has fallen off the wagon. The references to being on mushrooms yesterday, he mentioned it about four times.
Yeah.
I think you're wrong, John.
He's right. I'm going back to the...
You're off the rails.
Well, here's the thing.
I'm going back to the program tonight because I'm obviously a fucking drunk.
I wasn't here yesterday, but I didn't even think Jay Moore was in recovery. Even if he quit, some people stop and not in recovery and might dabble, and that's okay if that's what they do.
If you knew how dumb you looked with that fucking headphone on your head like that. Huh?
Tweet it, Jimmy, please. Huh? Can we tweet this?
It again.
Huh?
I know. I like that. Okay, huh? So,
hold on. That's the exact picture we leave on our door.
Oh, that's
Jimmy,
right.
We've already done
it. I know.
You know what's interesting to me anyway is I get like if I do a show and then I hit Twitter afterwards, and which is like pathetic because we do shows and you go on Twitter to go, did I do good, everyone? And then people go, he was obviously inebriated. Like that's
they said that.
People say that about me all the time, and I don't know what. Not like in clubs, but if I do like
because your eyes are too close together.
You know what? I gotta talk like Greg Hughes again here. Jay's never been more focused. Hasn't been this focused.
But wait a second,
on the show, it's been a great run. I don't want people to fucking tear this one down too.
You know,
I
get sober. A lot of people. Are you sober, or like I don't know.
I smoke grass once in a while.
Okay, so then why would they
say? I quit everything else.
Okay,
but I haven't smoked grass since. I don't remember the last time I did.
But so I guess how long have you been smoking the grass?
Well, I stopped split custody of my son. I stopped in case she said, "We'll drug test them," because you can say anything you want. So I stopped just in case, like that, because that'll come out of nowhere,
mm-hmm.
unprompted, and we're on the adoption waiting list. So I'm not.
I thought you're doing the ball surgery. We're
doing
about
all of it. We're going to adopt for Gardens.
Trying everything.
Wait.
I would adopt.
Split custody. You have custody of your son.
We split it.
Oh yeah,
we'll split it.
Is that a nightmare?
Wait, is this
not on Twitter?
What's that? Seeing the,
literally, it's business. We email.
Oh, you get it down.
You
to
drop
business.
Them off at school. I'll pick them up at school.
So it's just a business.
That's it.
Some people
you get along
can't
with your ex-wife.
Some people can't get business. To the business yeah. area.
Oh, see, me and my ex-wife got along great after.
But how does Bonnie get along with her?
Dude, well, you haven't heard this one? Moved. Hold on, no. I slow you down again. His ex-wife babysits the kid. How weird is that?
Do you ever think about going in there and giving her a fucking?
One for old
good
times'
old sake.
To get hard with Bonnie, I think of Kelly.
That's why Richard.
What have we got here? A fucking comedian.
How do you know these fucking buttons?
I don't know them.
He's
it's a magic
out.
Fucking
He's
thing.
Completely
I have.
Lucking out.
No, my wife. I was living 2 miles from my ex-wife, which we just moved to North Carolina.
Is she hot, your ex-wife?
She's sexy.
All right.
She's hotter than Bonnie.
Norton fucked her.
What?
Norton fucked my ex-wife.
Well,
did he really?
I found Dangerfield matches at my ex-wife.
Oh, I forgot. This is the other story, Jay. He's convinced that Jimmy, his wife.
I tried. We're divorced.
I was annoyed at first that he thought that, but then I'm just like, I kind of hope he does think that because I know it bothers him.
I hope he did.
Why do you
Florentine?
Think that?
You and Florentine split her in half.
Rich, why do you think that?
I knew Florentine was there because
the
I found a long blonde hair. Because when we were going to
her. Are you chewing gum again?
No.
Open your
Stop
mouth.
Stop chewing the gum, you addict.
Why would you say
just threw the other piece.
Why
People
would you say
hear
no?
it, dude. It's fucking driving
it
nuts.
Now
so let me ask you a question. Are you chewing the gum because you want a cigarette, or are you just chewing a gum because it's just a habit, like how some people bite their nails?
I'm addicted to the nicotine.
Really?
Yeah, and I'm addicted. I don't dabble. I do remember the last time I did it, which was a minute ago. I love it. I love it. Sometimes
it
you can fall
mic.
Asleep with it like this. You fall asleep. You wake up, you still have it, and you get some good flavor, and then you go back to bed, get some more flavor.
You
Stop doing
it.
Did you ever
addict.
Smoke? Did you ever smoke?
I did.
Did you quit?
Yep. You know how I quit? Whenever I wanted a cigarette, I dropped down. I did 15 diamond push-ups.
Dude.
Did you really?
Wait, is this a joke or real?
Nope.
I needed something.
So you
I
must have quit a while ago.
I quit in Vegas when we were doing.
Wait, yeah, because you want to come feel these fucking pipes, Mr. fucking
whoa,
skinny
whoa,
tattoo arms?
Oh, those pipes? Is that what they are?
Yeah. You guys see them without a shirt off.
Fucking
really?
Yeah, there's no fucking joke here.
Yeah.
Let me see your pipes. Let me see.
Fucking come touch them.
I'm not gonna
come over here. Come around, Jimmy.
It's okay to touch
you. Just can't.
What are you doing?
Hopefully, dying.
E-Rock, you did it too. I mean, sorry, Danny. Sorry.
No, I needed. You needed something to combat those cravings because they're just too intense. It's all you could think about. So I just kind of, I just figured every time I feel like I want one, I'll just go down and do 10 push-ups, like almost no matter where I am.
Diamonds, brother.
That's funny because you...
And after a few weeks, days, you don't even want to think about smoking because your arms are
jelly. But that helps.
I was going to 12-step meetings, and before the meetings, everybody would get down and do push-ups. Nothing.
Shucky ducky, crack, crack.
Hamburger, the joke was terrible.
Remember hamburger?
I used to work with those guys.
Hamburger.
Do you know Chucky Ducky?
I worked with him
once. Rich, you're chewing into the mic. It's driving me nuts.
I throw that out.
You got to stop.
Hold on. You remember the movie Magic?
Thank you, buddy.
You know, remember the movie Magic?
Yes.
How long you think he could go without putting another fucking piece of gum in his mouth?
I don't know.
Remember in Magic where, you know, he had to put the puppet down? It was that intense scene where he...
Fats.
I don't know if he lasted a minute. He had to grab it. I want to see how long it takes this fucking guy to go without putting another piece in.
Oh, all right.
It's because you chew it into the mic.
Now this has turned into a game show.
Or a game show.
So I had saliva back there.
Rich, can you go 15 minutes without a piece of gum in your mouth?
Easily.
Okay, good.
All right, we'll see. We're going to just go back to the show, and we'll see what happens.
So, I quit smoking.
Yeah.
But the hardest thing to quit was chewing tobacco because you can do it anywhere. You can do it on an airplane. You can do it on a show. I mean, I was just sitting here with a big wad of garbage in my mouth.
Oh, just dump it.
It's called your act.
Good. You know?
Shucky ducky. Quack, quack.
You knew Shucky Ducky?
I knew them all. I worked with all of them.
Did you know Chicken?
No, I never met that guy. I never met him.
I know.
Is there a Chicken guy?
It was.
He killed
himself. What was his deal?
He wasn't.
What was his deal?
Why do you wear your headphones like that?
It hurts my ear this year.
Why that ear?
But, like, I wear it behind like that, but I don't wear it. But I only have one ear covered. I hate having both ears covered. I never do.
Let me try that.
It's off my ear.
This is weird.
It's behind my ear.
I can't do that.
Let's all do it. It's nice. It's getting a nice breeze in there.
Yeah, it feels good.
Get some air on your ear.
How can you only talk into this? The sound quality of this drives me nuts.
Yeah, I hate talking into these mics.
But I hate having my ear. I hate
doing radio.
I just did a whip it. Jay Moore is clearly on drugs with the whip it reference. Fucking adults.
My favorite Devo song.
All right, should we break then?
No, this is going fine.
You need a piece of gum, don't you?
You got one in your mouth?
No.
Did you guys talk about Mitt?
Who?
Romney.
He's going to do an exploratory committee.
To see if he could be the president?
Have some fucking balls.
Just
and go,
do it.
Obama, suck my fucking Mormon cock. I'm in. 2012, Wu-Tang, forever. Like, just fucking call your shot.
Get Larry Merchant to
do it
for you.
I like that guy.
Do a boxing thing.
And Mitt Romney's a man. I love fucking Mitt Romney. But this exploratory committee, like, what?
They all do it.
You know what's great? The second you lose in fucking 2008, go, fuck that shit.
I'm coming
4 years, I'm fucking you up, bitch. Like in high school, like a bully beatdown. Just go, I'll see you in 4 years, bitch. And then go, all right, well, we know he's in.
Well, he lost to McCain. He didn't even lose to fucking Obama, okay? He didn't even get to fucking front.
It was too early for him. This is his time. And Jay's kind of right. If you're fucking go, you got to fucking go, I'm in.
It shows me.
I hate the exploratory thing.
That you're not sure how well you will do, in which point you got no fucking business being in there. Because if you want the job, you shouldn't give a shit how you would do. You should be driven by the fact that you know you could write the shit.
Well,
and if people don't vote for me, then I don't know what to fucking tell you. The people, they knew.
Mm-hmm.
The judges, they didn't know. Who knew what they knew?
Who's going to be the front runner?
Make him go first. Don't get out of the fucking ring.
You won.
Tell me why we had to come to Cleveland for you to get beat by a fucking Moulin. Why? Don't get out of the ring.
This fucking serial killer just got fucking bigger, man. CNN is live.
There's a skull found on Long Island.
No, well, they found 10 bodies, Jay. There's a serial killer. Everyone knows this area of Long Island. Fucking creepy. Ocean Parkway. Holy shit.
He's got a type.
He's up to 10.
Craigslist Hooker. There was a kid. There was a kid, too.
They found a kid?
Yes.
Yeah, 5-year-old.
When?
Probably, I guess yesterday, right?
Yeah. Yep.
That was one of the two they found?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
So there goes his comfort zone and his pattern.
Oh.
I bet you that the kid was with the mother. That's probably why. That was probably one of.
Yeah, they said that the.
That's
the,
what I would have said.
The remains were found close to an adult.
So what? The hookers bring the kids sometimes.
Not that I know, but he may have went to her.
It did in the deer hunter.
Yeah.
No, not with the kid in the room. Oh, no, man, not with the kid.
And they're still trying to find the one girl, so that means it's at least 11.
I like this fucking dolt on the news is holding up the missing poster on television.
Led to the beginning of this entire investigation. Carol?
I'm just curious, Alan, how remote is that area? I mean,
it's not
10
remote,
bodies
asshole.
Found?
It is tremendously remote. I mean, if you
it's
had to think of a
remote.
Place to dump bodies, this is actually
Smiths.
A terribly desolate stretch of Barrier Island. Right now, I'm standing at Jones Beach.
Alan, you know how off is awful.
You know how
it's hair like Roy Scheider
Beach nostril. In the New York area. To the east of me, for 15 miles straight, there's a highway that just extends very far. Very few people go there. Just a few hundred people. Live in beachside homes around here.
You know how busy Ocean Parkway is? What is he talking about? Fucking Danny knows.
Yeah.
Ocean Parkway is a busy fucking road.
Like it can be. It can be. You know, in spring and summer and stuff. Don't like winter, it can be desolate. I know what he's talking about, but
it's obviously a person that knows that area very well.
Yeah.
Very well.
Their comfort zone.
It's going to be a fucking someone that works for the park system
well,
or
they're saying it could be a cop.
Or a cop.
It could be ex-law enforcement.
Because if you're pulled over, it's so obvious. That
well, they
why
think...
are you pulled over in that stretch? They're going to fucking
and that's a tough
investigate.
Place. And that's a tough place to bring a body to if you had to do that. I don't know what's going on over here, so I'm just going to talk to you.
It's all right. Rich just
his headphones popped off his head. Like if you put a rubber band on your head, it would explode up.
If you were doing
his headphones.
If you were doing Ray Romano in the 80s.
You think you're going to
love it.
But remember that clip?
That's terrific.
I won't be doing that in Salt Lake this weekend.
Look, I'm going to tell you who the serial killer is. It's a guy that works for the park system or a cop. Simple as that. Because you can't just pull over to the side of the road without people going, what the fuck is that guy doing just on the side of the road? And the road's busy enough where that would happen.
Might be very late.
Might be very late. Might be at 4 a.m. or 4:03.
People, let's just say, people go there to fucking, you know, have sex in cars and stuff, and the cops are always stopping
on
people.
Fire.
Well, he has
always.
Call
cop,
you can't, in a cop
you can't
car.
Park a car in the middle of the night there without someone knowing. And you can't do it basically during the day because there's a lot of traffic. It's an inside guy. I'm
he's obviously been
you.
Doing it for a while. He probably hasn't dumped there in a while.
I'm
and obviously now
you.
He'll dump somewhere else.
It's someone that really does know that area and knows when to. Well, I mean, if it's like a
Lost
cop car or something,
you
on the
fucking.
All right.
You got a lot of people wanting to defend you, Richard.
On what?
On the fucking telephones.
Let me say hi to this guy.
This is great when the subject matter says Voss had a great joke about leaving a load.
Oh, I know.
Nothing says class.
Hey, Jay. Yeah, I saw Voss on that tour. They didn't really rip you off, but he did have this one great line about leaving a map of Hawaii on a chick's stomach.
Good.
What was this?
Yeah.
Me?
Yeah, I've lost it, Dad.
No. I never said that in my life. Thank you, but I never said it. It's probably something else. Where? What tour?
I wrote that.
What tour?
Can you rule?
All right. All right, we're going to take a break and regroup.
Oh, my chest hurts.
Yeah, Voss, you just have brought the laughs today. They're going to love you in Salt Lake. Wise Guys Comedy Club. We don't have to promote this. It's 80 people.
What do you
sold
make
out,
there?
Right?
What's that?
Show me with your tiny finger. Yeah. I won't say it out loud.
Show me with your finger.
You're going to think it's half.
I already did that.
He
told me, no, I'm a big deal.
I have to promote something.
Do they pay for your plane?
Yeah.
They do airfare buyouts.
Who's the guy that called as Rich? That was a tremendous show.
Bob
DeBono.
Is he around?
I would love to hear him today. Louis Ferranda. I can't do tour deals, Jimmy. It'll kill me.
Yeah.
His kid's good. Oh, God. Jimmy. Where's Linda Smith? My God, when you need her.
Jimmy, it's to you.
I have the Antisocial Comedy. Just go to antisocialcomedy.com. We have dates on sale now in Las Vegas, D.C., and the opening night of the Chicago Comedy Festival. Connecticut is sold out, and they will sell out as well.
Nice. I'm going to fucking hit
some. I'm at Gotham tonight. That will not sell out.
Why?
Because it's in Chelsea with the gay boys. It's half slice.
It's also Tuesday. It's tough.
Tuesday's tough.
Why are you not here this weekend? Just a week?
I'm in Borgata Saturday.
Oh.
Saturday. $25 ticket though tonight. It's not or $20. It's you know.
Can I get a room at the Borgata? I'm going.
Are you sold out in the Borgata?
Let's go.
I doubt it.
Then you should be plugging that.
You should be plugging
Borgata. I'm at the Borgata Theater.
Gotham.
Saturday, Borgata Theater.
Well, they're different markets. I mean, if you're in New York, go to
sure.
Gotham.
No, nah, we like the Gotham people.
If you're in the Borgata's the best hotel in the country.
Except for the guy that yelled at me when I walked in with a hat because I didn't want to disturb Jay's fucking show, and the guy almost threw me out.
For wearing a hat?
Did you do snow climbing?
You can't wear hats in Gotham?
Nope. Snow climbing. And the guy, the security guard, I was like, okay. But he was fucking pissed. And almost, I never told you this. I almost got thrown out. Because I wore a hat. He was really fucking upset.
Where?
And then the owner apologized.
In a casino?
Jesus Christ.
At the Borgata? At the Borgata?
Yes.
E-Rock just
you,
hit
yes.
Or
no, what do you do?
I was
you're half a year.
What happened? You're 5 feet away huh? from me.
No fucking way.
Yes.
In a 100-seat room.
I'm telling you.
What do you got? What number?
Don't say it on the air. Don't.
No. What a jackass.
I'll tell you off the air.
Yeah, no,
no way.
Way.
That's yeah, what I said. No way.
I'm telling you,
you're pumping
why
your numbers
I
up.
I'm
you're
telling you why.
I know exactly. Give me a pen.
All right,
right here.
No, no, oh. Fuck. I would never do that.
Thurman Munson.
I wouldn't do that at home for that. I wouldn't.
What
do
the
that.
Fuck kind of person? I would.
I forgot Thurman's number.
No, no.
Nope. Yeah.
That's you, right
guarantee
there.
Guarantee I'm not. I'll show you the email. I
oh
believe
my
him.
God, are you can fucking hear your phlegm you gargling around in your own throat.
Yeah.
All right, we're gonna.
What's in his mouth? You fucking faggot prick!
It's in my mouth the whole time, you fucking homos.
How long ago did you put the gum back in?
He totally got us, Jimmy.
That's how. Right. That's what an actor I am. You can't tell.
Oh, there's no gum?
No, it's in his mouth.
Yeah,
he never took
out
it out. He fucking faked spitting. He
no,
faked
no,
spitting
up in my
it
lip.
Out. What a fucking cunt.
Oh, that's real. That's nice. That's really nice.
That's
now, now we're doing British radio.
I don't even like that word. You've forced me to say it.
Why aren't you wearing underwear?
What are you doing now?
Why aren't you doing underwear? Why aren't you wearing underwear?
That's what he does when he can't think of the word that he needs. He punches in his stomach.
All that comes out. All right, we've seen your asshole.
God.
It doesn't matter. We've seen it, Rich.
You know what? What's more humiliating?
I showed it to Bonnie, and she almost threw up. She was in the kitchen. She came around.
Yeah, it's a oral medium. You're going to have to fucking figure out the mic.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to break.
Oh.
Jay Moore, Borgata.
Or AU. I
this
fucking
weekend.
Clicked him out.
And Jim Norton gave all the dates and maybe.
Antisocialcomedy.com.
Yeah. That's a crazy
that.
Ass okay. Great show.
Just
you
hit
put
that
together.
Please.
Yeah.
Virus, Sirius XM. This is the Opie and Anthony Show. Opie.
That's why we're playing this.
I'm guessing it's on the tech stuff.
There's two things. Ozzy received a star on the Walk of Fame 9 years ago. Good whatever. Day. And he owes money. The Osbournes owe 1.7.
Wow.
How does that happen?
You're probably okay. Just bad bookkeeping. Sharon said it was
not
her
right
fault.
Right
yeah,
off.
Not right off. Nothing.
Well, it's Draco Jake. It's ginger ale.
50. It's 700,000 for 1 year and a million for the next year. They'll take care of it.
That's like three shows at the Meadowlands.
That's
yeah,
nothing.
Not right off.
Not right off.
I like all these calls about Rich being a fucking FBI profiler.
It's great.
I'm not going to tell you to fucking do your own show.
Well, we've been doing less calls, but we could go to Brooklyn. Tony!
I love this.
Tony!
Hello? Just say hi, everybody on the phones.
Thanks, Jay Morse.
Sorry.
You fucking...
Hello?
Tony, you fuck.
He's not
the guy
there.
From Brooklyn.
He's not there.
Oh, yeah, let's get someone else.
Yeah, but it's a good call. Since Voss is an FBI profiler, what is his opinion on this serial killer?
What is your opinion?
Well, it's a lot of anger, childhood anger. He probably had a speech impediment, and he probably came from a broken home, and his mother was very overpowering or overbearing. And he's, you know, transforming his aggression that he...
Transforming.
Like, it's not that big
okay.
Of a deal.
And, you know, and he's getting back with his mom. It's a lot of them do it that way.
Have you gotten back with your mom?
Yeah.
Did you?
Yeah.
Would you tell her that you were mad at her?
Oh, no. How did I get back with my mom? I told her I loved her, and that's how you let things go.
Attaboy. You and your mom had a problem? A lot of, yeah.
Me.
Both
no,
of you.
You know,
you
know. You
didn't get any
affection. You didn't come from a broken home.
No.
My house, all the walls were fine.
Chip, goddamn Chip, you kill me. Bobby Kelly and you should go out together.
He's too stupid.
You should have been here when Ricky Gervais mistook Jimmy for Bobby Kelly.
That was a sad moment. It really was a sad moment.
I saw you at the Comedy Cellar, and I was laughing because Louis said something in my ear, and I laughed so hard it was distracting.
No, I was actually glad that he mixed us up there because that's embarrassing. Because
Bob Kelly thought that he,
that he got Richie, a laugh from Ricky.
That he made Ricky Gervais laugh, and it was because Louis C.K. whispered something into Ricky's ear.
But
and
then Bob Ricky probably just knew you. Didn't he put you in a movie?
No.
Oh, no, that's Kevin.
Yeah. No, he does. We've interviewed him before. He knows me, but he mixed me up with that fucking.
Like he knows you, like from the cellar and stuff, and
just from through Louis, yeah. I think. And I'm sure he's seen Lucky Louis.
What was Louis doing on his computer during that interview?
He was probably looking at stuff that he had shot. He's shooting a series.
Yeah.
So and he's that overwhelmed with work. That
but he edits, he does everything himself.
Wow. Yeah, he does it all.
He's an animal.
I'm a nincompoop on the computer. Dude, emails only. People are like, did you get it? I'm like, I don't have a fucking printer in my house. Fucking drop it in the mailbox like Paulie and Goodfellas. Come by.
Mailbox? What's that?
But people go, I sent you all your flight information. I go, well, then I don't have my flight information because it's in my computer. And I don't know.
Well, you don't get it through email and stuff?
I get it, but I don't have a printer in my house, and I don't
How
know.
How do you not have a printer? Like, I love
Because I'm a fucking stooge.
Well, you just do it on your phone.
Get a printer in your house.
I can get, I get stuff on my phone, but then I forget.
I like writing stuff and printing it, and you got to have a printer.
You really do.
I love having a printer.
You need a printer.
I take great pride in it.
Now, are you more pro-printer or more pro-easy
Oh, my God, we're not going to do this on this show.
What?
What?
Am I more pro-printer or pro-easy pass?
I have a printer.
I'm for both.
He tells you Stop all the things gum. You have to get in life that makes his life
no
easier.
One's a pro. Yes, they make everyone's life easier.
That's not true.
Easy pass?
It might not. You don't know.
Who,
no, no,
how?
No,
how? Like, how?
Yes,
because maybe if you're trying, if you don't want to be tracked,
he doesn't have it to be tracked.
You don't want to be tracked.
You're
down.
Not that important. They're not going to. They're not easy to find
you're
anyway.
Some people.
Do you have credit cards, profiler?
Yes,
exactly.
I do.
So they fucking track you there
everywhere.
Not
all they gotta do is go
do
fucking from empty
Say
comedy club to empty comedy club.
To Long Island.
What'd you say? I didn't hear
all they gotta do is go from empty comedy club to empty comedy club.
That was fantastic.
Very good. Very good.
No one is a pro printer. Ooh, threw the gum away.
Yeah, you did. How could you not? You were an inch away from the cup.
Abdul-Jabbar. Did you see mine and Rich's hands together? Do it again, Rich.
Come on, Rich. Put your little turtle feet hands up.
Turtle pants.
Yeah, put those turtle
feet. Your best line is visiting. No, it's line them up for real.
Line it up.
Line it up. Look.
Oh, what a child.
He's got a gambling habit.
What? Child. So,
what's his name? Cookie jar. Cookie jar when we were. He's got a gambling problem.
We, me and Rich Voss were at the Continental Hotel watching Cookie Jar, the lounge singer.
And Bruce Smirnoff.
Me, Rich, and Bruce Smirnoff. And Rich goes to the craps table and throws all his fucking money away, comes back to the craps table, goes, could you loan me $100? And I go, sure. And then he goes to the craps table and he comes back. It's the same song and he comes back.
Oh, my
like
God.
He's fucking, he just put $100, sticks the hard way, and he loses it again. And the singer's on stage, and he leaves a three trip. And now at this point, I don't want him to pay me back. I just want to feed this fucking addiction and watch it in front of my
see
eyes.
Where it goes.
That's
right.
My entertainment
right.
for the night.
Yeah.
So I'm like 600 into his fucking habit. It's the same song. If you don't know me by now, handcuff him to the chair. He's got a fucking sickness. You'll never have a. The guy actually fucking yelled that at Voss. From the
Holy
stage.
Remember Brandy?
You'll never. Yeah, Voss had some seven that he was fucking parading
she
around
was,
Vegas.
She was definitely
a seven.
Nine.
A Voss seven is a fucking everyone else nine and a half.
That's good for me.
I'm saying it's a bell curve that how you judge women. Like, we all are surprised that you married somebody as beautiful and talented as
Bonnie. I always
had
hot girls in my fucking life.
Because you had coke.
No, after. I got a resume.
Because
got,
they thought you had coke.
No, you fucking moron.
Why do I sound like Colin? Shut your face.
I have pictures of home of the hottest fucking girls.
That's fucking good. That's good for marriage. That's
I keep them hidden in the basement, dummy. I go down there to fucking spank one out.
Yeah. I guess Bonnie doesn't listen to the show. Do you really go to the basement and check out old fucking photographs? You're a serial killer, man.
Yeah, what are you keeping a fucking chock full of nuts fucking can?
That's where you put your photos in. That's where you put the 8x10s. I got them in a fucking briefcase.
A briefcase?
A briefcase.
Yeah. Oh, you fucking.
Yeah, that's how old she'll it is. She'll never think to look there.
Yeah, exactly. A briefcase in the basement with cum stains on it.
Yeah, a briefcase is way more normal than a fucking coffee can.
Rich says, there's nothing under here but a bunch of papers.
What does Bonnie think in the briefcase?
Exactly. You're a young lawyer.
You actually said that. You had the serial. You said the serial killer. I picture you on a golf course going, well, the serial killer has a speech impediment.
I don't talk like that. Only with a couple letters. You're fucking up every letter.
C-H.
So. Yeah, and S.
Say so three.
No, we just said, this is what we did on Last Comic Standing. To make me happy, you said I had sushi in church Tuesday.
I could say it perfectly.
All right. Go ahead.
And try it. I had sushi. Oh, hold on.
It's not Sue.
I had sushi. It's
Sue?
Jawbone.
Sushi in church on Tuesday.
I'm not your fucking game. I don't play that shit. If I was crippled.
What do you mean?
If I had like a fucking fucking no legs, you would say get up and dance.
Yeah, we would. Yeah, how great would that be?
Just as tall as you are now.
My hands against your hands looks like we're fucking
exactly
like Father Sunday.
Just molesting you.
Show.
You have bigger hands.
Say the sushi again.
No, enough already.
Say church.
No.
What do you mean no? Come like on. Now?
What else are we gonna do? Else are we gonna do?
Come on, guys, lay off.
Yeah. Go to the we lost the show hours ago. What else are we gonna
look
do?
Look at the
hours. Hours.
Do the church thing.
More.
No. Do it for church. Fucking Jay Morris. Yes.
There you go.
It was perfect.
Love it.
But I say a couple of bad letters. I don't say every word like
no,
that.
No, I know you don't.
Do you really have a briefcase with pictures in it?
Of old girlfriends?
Of old girlfriends? It's so fucked up.
It's a hard briefcase.
You don't remember? Really does Bonnie know that
you can't
have
just
it?
Do the spank?
Does she hear the telltale click of an opening at fucking 2 in the morning?
Is there a lock on it? You need the combination?
Don't touch me, you freak.
It's not because he's a freak. It's because we all know you get really uncomfortable.
Who wants to be? There's too many uncomfortable things that go on in here.
What?
Like I love you. I love you. That love thing. I love
yeah,
you.
What?
We don't say I love you.
They say it all
exactly.
The time.
Where are you?
When's the last time we said that?
He doesn't know where he is.
I love you. Somebody called. I love you guys. I love you.
Yeah, that's uncomfortable when people say express their admiration.
Yeah, it's just common speak.
See, I don't say it like that.
Yes, you do.
You never heard it.
Say admiration.
Yes, you do.
Jimmy had the line because you've never heard it.
It's a great line, right?
It's true. I can't believe she got knocked off last week.
Say admiration.
Hey, did you guys
You watch American Idol?
Yeah.
You know Pia? I just know because they're talking about
it. Yeah, I can't believe
I know onomatopoeia. Oh, shit.
Did you guys have Trump on?
His son. He's a great guy, actually. We had a good time.
What one? Trump the one that
he's
likes.
A good guy for a billionaire son, yeah.
There's two of them. There's two kids.
It was Don Jr.
Don Jr.
It's like the bosses.
Not the blonde-haired. Blonde
the other one.
Trump.
Blonde-haired is the golf courses.
And what? I'm being completely serious. I can't fucking believe your daughter's 18 years old. Like
18 and 20. I have a 20-year-old,
Jesus.
Too.
Jesus.
We were in the Poconos. They were like, fuck, we're playing fucking good old days now. I apologize.
Where were we in the Poconos?
You and I did some gig together in the Poconos. Yeah. It was like, your kids were like 6 and 8. It was cool.
Yeah, we did a gig in the Poconos.
Remember you're headlining Mount Airy Lodge?
He was.
That was 2 weeks ago.
No. He was.
They were there. Oh, that was the weekend my fucking wife was leaving me. That's the weekend. Oh, I fucking, that was OJ weekend.
Why are these black guys walking through like, yo, that's mad crazy in there, son.
They just pointed, shade 45.
But they pointed in here like, that's Jim Norton's.
No,
they didn't. Yes, they did.
Then let's go get them. Who are they?
If it's black people, I'm the one who's getting recognized.
Will you talk about the wife? She left you that weekend when you were doing the Poconos with Jay Moore?
That was my ex-wife. Yeah, I think that was OJ
weekend.
Where can
we find a photo of your ex-wife?
Huh?
She's pretty.
What's going on? What's the touching?
Where can we find a photo of your ex-wife?
Do you have one?
No.
Why not?
Is that in the briefcase? Is that
in
the briefcase?
I'm in a briefcase.
Is it in the briefcase?
Has Bonnie ever caught you masturbating? Be honest.
No.
Wife caught me masturbating.
Really?
Yep.
You never caught?
I was.
You know what she said to me?
What?
She said, is that something you need to do? We were at a hotel.
And I was, we had already had sex and she went to sleep. And then I was watching a porno. Did I tell this already?
Yeah. It's okay. Tell it again for Rich. And
Then, so she was asleep. And so I didn't want to wake her up. So I went in the room and I put on like a movie on the pay-per-view and I jerked off. And then she saw me, but she didn't tell me. And it was like 3 weeks later, we're in the car, like driving to Vegas. We're in the middle of the desert. And she goes, when you masturbate, is that something like you need to do? And I was like, what? And she goes, you know, like porno and stuff. Is that what you need to do? And I'm like, I act like I had no idea what she was talking about. She goes, okay, well, just so you know, I'm kind of a sure thing. Like, you can wake me up. And I was like, oh, okay. So then porno goes out the window.
I was masturbating a couple weeks ago. And I talk about this. And I didn't want to, but I did. Yeah, and I wasn't even hard. I was semi-hard, and I came. I didn't know
yeah,
that
yeah, yeah, yeah.
Can Many, that happen?
Yes. For 30 years
no,
I've been
it
doing
can't.
That.
You just said it happened.
Well, I mean, yeah, what do you think? Your dick is
put in the Smithsonian?
It's amazing.
Under the spirit of 76? Yeah. Right.
Your cock is different than any other cock on the planet.
It certainly is.
Did he actually say, can that happen? After
no, I mean, you know what I mean.
Said it is happened? That, what, do you, what does Rich Voss masturbate to?
Pictures of full crowds.
Sold out show. I was going to say that.
Sold out signs.
Third show in.
What, at the Trolley
Square?
What
do I think about? I don't know.
Wise yeah, Guys Comedy Club?
You
Rich
think
Voss
about
this
stuff?
Weekend?
You know, yeah. You know you got porno on the laptop.
Yeah, what do you,
right?
No.
What?
No. I have no porno.
He has to erase his history.
No, he got to go down to the, he has to go down to the briefcase.
No,
what else
I
is in the briefcase?
Porno. Old, old calendars and old different things back in the day and just old stuff for me and audience. And just I'll bring in the pictures. You want to see
no,
some
I'll
hot
bring
girls.
In the briefcase. Yeah. Don't bring in just the photos. Bring in that fucking
we
briefcase.
We need the briefcase.
We would love
that
to see.
Is the FBI's
I want to see
can
your...
we go through your briefcase? That would be hilarious.
Yeah, I'll do that next time.
Keep everything in there. Try to at least.
I won't
I'm
touch
sure
anything.
You'll,
I won't
sure
even
you'll
open
take
it.
Some shit
I swear to God, I won't even open it.
Dude,
bring
how
it
great
there.
Would that be if he brings his briefcase?
I'll bring Dude, it. It's not my briefcase from now. From 20 years.
I got you.
Well, that's the beauty of it is to have it from so long ago.
Move over.
All right, I will.
Oh.
Oh, boy, now you've
Whoa!
Done it.
Whoa, look at this. All three of us.
You can't sit that close to anybody.
Rich, when you masturbate, you just use your imagination?
I don't look. I don't like
look
looking at
Danny. Look, he's
look
at Danny's
away.
Oh.
Look, he's moving away.
I don't look. I don't. No,
I'll touch Jimmy. Jimmy will touch you.
I look at ahead. Some pictures.
Jimmy's got such a nice touch.
What are you doing, Rich? My
underwear stuck in my balls. You know what I mean? When they creep up on you.
No, because my ass, my underwear, sorry.
Are we high and I don't know it? What the fuck is going on?
I couldn't get it out. No, because my balls don't have a crack in them like my asshole is what I was trying to say.
I should have just said. A double?
One of them.
Oh, all right, so you're bringing the briefcase in.
Yeah, I'm bringing it. When?
Next week, please. Let's not wait on this one.
All right. All
right.
So when you're in this week, you're just like banking vacation time at this point? Because you were supposed to be off this week?
Yeah, I think we're going to shut it down. It's obvious we need to shut it down after today.
But are these like...
We finally reached our limit.
Are these like 2 days that you didn't have to come in and you can use later for vacation
Oh, fuck
time?
Yeah. I'll get it on the other side. Some Fridays off or something. Yeah, and we'll be back Monday.
So, Rich, you're going to be at Trolley Square, Wise Guys, in Salt Lake City.
Yeah.
Those tickets are on sale. Go on.
I'm gonna tell you something. We were at, where were we? Arizona? The famous Arizona story. And George Bush was staying at the fucking hotel. And me and I called up Rich. He came to my hotel hanging out. And all of a sudden we go, let's go check out the Bush thing. And they were
Secret Service.
They fucking recognized Rich Voss. Last Comic Standing fame. They're like, holy shit, that's Rich Voss.
The Biltmore. That was at the Biltmore.
The Biltmore. What a fucking place. Holy
that's
shit.
That's where the basketball players stay, too.
Well, then there was a hooker at the bar. Do you remember this?
And that's where Rich went.
And there, no, she was trying to pick up that guy, and we fucking blew up her spot, and she got so mad at us. We were just complete dicks.
I stayed at the St. Regis a couple weeks ago, about a month ago. That was fucking a whole nother world, man.
Yeah.
It was a comp.
Why was it a whole nother world?
We had a butler. I didn't know what to do.
Yeah,
he knocked on the door.
St. Regis.
Goes, I'm your butler.
How did you get, like, what made you go, let's go stay at the St.
Why
Regis?
Why St. Regis?
Because we did a fundraiser, a free benefit for the blind, and they threw us.
Do they know they put you at the St. Regis?
Too bad it wasn't for the deaf. Whoa.
I haven't done that today. But.
So you, so you said you. They put you up at the St. Regis?
No, it was one of the.
Was
kids.
It a suite?
Sorry.
They put us up. Leading up to that the whole
we
time.
We did that at the Ritz Carlton down in Florida.
And Miami. So then they. And then they put you up at the St. Nice. Regis the as same night.
No.
Yeah.
Yeah, with you hit him.
I can't even fucking talk. Jesus Christ, Jimmy's killing me. I've never heard I've never heard it.
Oh boy.
Wow. Don't you just
yeah.
Not
he'll,
now.
He'll work it out.
Yeah. But I believe it starts with huh?
Yeah.
Huh? Huh? So, Voss, have fun in Salt Lake City.
You all right, Rich?
This is why I talk so much, because Opie enjoys that he can, kick back and relax.
I don't give a fuck.
So, like, when it's me and
I get paid either way.
Yeah, so I'm like, I hear the dead air, and I go, so, Voss, you're going to be... No, and then people are like, fucking shut up, Jay Moore.
No, I talk enough.
I was reading reviews. Everybody loves you.
Why do you read that shit? Why do you give fucking credibility to these fucking scumbags?
Because it was on my email.
Who send fucking their thoughts through the internet because they have no one with actual ears that will listen to their fucking words.
It's a good point, Rich.
I see you on fucking the message board that I'm not going to name. Right now they're typing, he's talking about us.
Who? Yeah, but wait, if you see me, why are you reading it?
I used to. I quit Twitter. I'm not even fucking doing any of that shit anymore.
You tweeted.
You don't do Twitter anymore?
I fucking hate it.
Yeah,
because you're looking
at a lot of negativity.
But let's say it's not. You're looking at it for the fucking positive. It's the gayest, most fucking pathetic. What are we fucking 12-year-old at a school play? Did we do good, mommy?
No.
Like you just were here. It was fun with your friends.
No, you're reading for some funny stuff.
You shouldn't have to go on a social media network to go. I wonder how it went. Like we were here. We broke each other's balls. I'm gonna walk in the elevator today, going. I had a fucking ball. Jimmy touched Rich the whole show. It made me laugh. We talked off the air about some personal stuff. We got some shit out of the way about not you and me, an argument. You know what I'm talking about. And it's fucking great. If I go on fucking Twitter, there's going to be out of 60 comments, 20 of them are going to be like, what? That's why do they have him in there?
They say that
21. Once I get on, here's the thing. You might read some, funny lines. There's some good lines.
What am I
going to
use them?
No,
that's your fucking new material? When Corvette Guy 420 drops a fucking funny? And it's the anonymity that disgusts me.
Yeah.
Like fucking Tree Fort Mike and fucking Gang Rape Magoo and all these fucking assholes like fucking dog shit in the vagina. And like all these people like, you fucking suck. And I'm like, well, that's nice. You have an entire Wikipedia page and a career to go on. And all I can say back to you is, nice profile pic, asshole. Like it's fucking ridiculous. You're arguing with fucking fate. You're ghosts. Right. It's like the fucking Viet Cong. They're fucking fighting ghosts out there, man. Okay, lunch lady 4-5. Like what? Like you fucking and you
lady trucker.
You fucking argue with these people.
I fight with them.
And
do you
I
really?
Wanted
Why?
To. I want to create. I've already patented this.
No, don't say it.
All right, you're right. Because I'm gonna steal it.
No, we actually got a business fucking thing.
Who does?
Me and Jay.
Just forget
you
it.
You don't get a piece. Sorry.
Oh.
Me and Jay.
How many people do you block?
He hit. Don't say shit.
I'm not fucking talking about the other thing.
Don't say the other thing either.
I'm not.
Because the other thing should be a surprise.
How many people do you block?
A couple a day.
Yeah. A couple a day.
Why?
I've blocked a total of 10 people so far.
What I'm saying is, you shouldn't have to. When you go to your Twitter account, which you joined for two reasons. You join Twitter to have some fucking laughs.
Mainly
and to sell
to promote.
Tickets.
To promote.
Right.
Yeah.
So, but to have some laughs, like I'm going to type something and I'm playing golf. This people that are Rich Voss fans can go, oh, I live here. This is where I play golf too. This is kind of interesting to me. And then they just tweet back, you're a mushmouth faggot. And you're like, then what the fuck? Like, why? What is the fucking, it's babble. It's a tower of fucking babble.
I agree with you. I agree with you. But for promoting purposes, you know, I'm not just going to get on there and go.
You're going to tell me Twitter fucking works?
No.
That's why Ashton Kutcher movies opened to fucking $5 million a weekend. The guy has 7 million fucking followers. If half of his followers saw his movies, he'd be fucking bigger than Tom Cruise in China.
Well, okay, here's the thing.
In China?
I'm not
Tom's big in China.
I believe.
Why? You don't believe in promotions at all? You don't believe in promotions at all?
I believe when I hit that fucking town, I hit the radio stations where the comedy club knows what radio stations go to the demographic. I give them everything I got. I fucking put on a big show, and then I go back. And then you do the show. You shake people's hands once in a while.
That's what I don't. I don't shake hands.
Why I like not? When they. I like when they. I like when they get on the.
There's
like,
a flinch that
people stopped. Started getting shitty on Twitter, going like, "Yeah, thanks for not doing a fucking meet and greet." I'm like, "Yeah, remember I did an hour and a half and a standing ovation? I thought that's where our relationship ended. I didn't know I had to fucking go in the lobby and fucking work the crowd like a goddamn caucus. Say caucus.
Caucus. See, no problem there,
no,
baby.
It was a good one.
That's why you said it.
But you of all people, Rich.
Yeah.
I can imagine you must just be fucking beyond frustrated when you go to your mentions page on Twitter.
Oh, sometimes. Yeah, but here's the problem.
Sometimes?
Yeah, because these
go
guys
to it
think,
right now.
No, I know.
And
these
I guarantee
guys think,
you, you're right, a fucking think, piece of shit tenfold right
they
now.
Think that, right. They think that they are Opie and Anthony and Patrice and Norton. They think that they... They don't know the difference between radio and real life. They don't get it. They don't
go
get
go to your mention page right now.
Leave them alone.
No, I'm trying to get them off Twitter.
I'm looking at my app mentions. No. How old is he? That shirt is for 20-year-olds. Nice rugby shirt. Isn't he late for homeroom?
These are on yours?
Oh.
Oh, because you tweeted the picture of him with the headphones.
Hey,
right?
Jim Norton, are you sure that Voss doesn't have partial Down syndrome?
See, that's why you go to Twitter.
And the replay, you got to bleep out that guy. That guy.
Yeah, we
last
will.
Name.
We will. You fucked it up, Jay Morse.
I did. All right, I'm going to go to my Twitter account, which I haven't tweeted.
Danny tried to save you, by the
way.
We did.
We
let it be known.
We got it.
What? He's getting
a lot. Oh, we did get it. Yeah, it's all good.
You know what? I did that Watch What Happens Live, that show, that Andy Cohen show.
Yeah.
All my fucking tweets were positive. Fucking gay people telling me I'm fabulous.
Half Slices.
Where was this?
The Half Slice crew. It's a housewife thing on Bravo.
What did you say, Rich?
I said, where was this?
It was down
oh, you want to do the show?
What is it?
Who's booking that show?
Who? What is it? I don't say that.
It's a hot new thing.
It's, yeah, everyone's doing it.
What is it?
Forget it. I'm surprised they haven't called you.
All right.
They should have called you by now.
You know what's amazing? When you quit Twitter.
His
like,
eyes look lazy.
I'm tired. I slept 3.5 hours.
Oh, my love.
3.5 hours.
A month goes by not being on Twitter, and you get like, I look at my phone, there's like 150 mentions. I'm like, I'm not there.
But you are.
You're there by being.
No, I go, I pull it down. I just did it now for emphasis. I'll pull it down. I'll hit Twitter. And then I just go back. And then I just do
when
that.
When are you going to get an iPhone?
I got to get one because this phone is a fucking bag of dog shit.
Yeah,
what
know.
Is it?
My Touch. Can you text? It's all to My Touch. Let's see some touching. Why don't you let Jimmy just touch your leg? Just let him rub it for 10 ridiculous. Seconds. Why don't you let him rub your leg for 10 seconds like this on Opie's flip phone?
Oh. Stop with the gum.
Why are you taking another piece out?
I'm getting ready for...
Would you stop now with them?
Yeah.
Start with the toys.
You called those Nicorettes? Did you eat them?
I got no choice. Rich, what's your favorite movie of all time?
Days of Wine and Roses.
Jesus.
Or, what? That's a great answer.
It's a good answer.
What do you mean?
He just thinks it makes it sound smart.
No,
and
it
like
doesn't.
He likes all
like
hold on. Here's the $1 million question. Who's in it?
Jack Lemmon and Lee Remick.
All right. So you're Jack Lemmon.
Do you listen to music when you're right around or talk radio?
Talk radio.
What do you?
Why? I listen to Hannity.
Talk radio stinks. I used to listen a lot, too.
You're doing it, you fucking
weird talk radio.
Now, this is comedy is different than fucking political talk.
No, it isn't. You call this comedy? This is fucking dead talk radio.
Political talk is fucking horrendous.
But when you listen to music, what do you listen to, Rich?
I listen to old music, what I like.
Write down your top five Rolling Stones.
Exile on Main Street, 39 years ago today.
My
Thank you.
Favorite?
Rich, go ahead. What do you listen to when you're not doing the talk
I got,
radio
I got
thing?
Some of my greatest hits. I put them on CDs.
What
and
is
I play it?
It
in the car. Temptations, Cat Stevens.
Wait, CDs? Fucking... What about your iPod? Oh, you don't have a connection?
What?
Do you have an iPod?
Yeah.
Temptations. I've been happy. Rich, who's that person on TV? Who's that
it's
boy?
From American Idol.
No.
No, that's the guy from Bravo. From,
what's his name?
From Project Runway.
Christian Siriano.
Okay.
You know why I know that?
Because you're a fag.
I'm gay. He's a fag.
He's got his gaze. You need your
I'm
gaze.
I'm working on my gaze because they'll never fucking leave you. And when you're old and you're a has-been like Rich, that's when they like you the most.
That is true.
I did myself.
All right.
Rich,
Margaret Cho eyes.
What temptation?